He has done a lot of things to me. So no, I don't regret calling him that word. Because any man, I don't care what skin color you are, any person who tries to steal your house and your home is a fucking murderer.
Fucking poor little fucking thug bitches.
I love black people.
Fucking thug bitches.
I love black people.
And they said something they didn't like, it was automatically that fucking nigger.
I love black people.
Black lives matter.
I love black people.
Black lives matter.
I love black people.
Well, these black lives matter, they did take a meal peacefully. And you didn't fucking listen to them.
Is there a lingering racism in me? Maybe.
I'm with Ice Cube.
Yeah.
I'm with Ice T.
Yeah.
I'm with Snoop Dogg.
I love black people.
Yeah.
You want me to feel good about black people after being robbed?
I love black people.
Yeah.
The fuck you are, nigger. It just came out.
Because I'm not a racist, I love black people.
Yeah.
I'll be fucking racist all day long. Because I'm not a racist, I love black people.
Yeah.
But it's okay for them to call me a white nigger.
Because I'm not a racist, I love black people.
Yeah.
They think what they do, they can get away with because they're black.
I love black people.
Yeah.
Go fuck yourselves, all of you.
Because I'm not a racist, I love black people.
Yeah.
I don't owe you shit, nigger.
Yes, you do.
I love black people.
Fucking thug bitches.
I love black people.
Fucking thug bitches.
I love black people.
And they said something they didn't like, it was automatically that fucking nigger.
I love black people.
Black lives matter.
I love black people.
Black lives matter.
I love black people.
Well, these black lives matter, they did take a meal peacefully. And you didn't fucking listen to them.
Is there a lingering racism in me? Maybe.
I'm a Niger. Like a major Niger. You can derive what word I'm saying without saying it.
White nigger. Call me a white nigger.
I'm a Niger. I'm a Niger. I'm a Niger. Like a major Niger.
I'm part Nigerian, which is where we get the N-word. So does that give me clout in the community? I'm just reporting facts, folks. That's all I'm doing. I'm like Alex Jones reporting facts.
I'm a Niger. I'm a Niger. I'm a Niger. Like a major Niger.
Like when you accept Jesus, it changes your DNA. I believe that.
What the fuck is so interesting about Michelle Obama? And what the fuck did she do in the White House that made her so great anyway? And is it because she's black? Is that the only greatness she has, is she's black? And
you want to try to be in the cool I'm not racist card game?
I'm not racist card game.
Hello, 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 beautiful creatures of the internet. I'm your armchair quarterback, Mango Jones. If I sound like I feel like shit, it is because I feel like shit. I did this thing where, you know, not only have I fucked up my hip, but I also gave myself a nice mild case of food poisoning last night. So I'm going through it. Happy Eclipse Day. Yeah. We have, Naked and Laughing, an edit done by Mr. Fat Photog. We have Revan Shanny stuff. We have Tony Chase. We have a horrible fucking food recipe. So let's do the spiel. We'll say hi to the folks. We'll get into the shit. Small human, if you could breathe like a people, I would really appreciate it. Close enough. Alright, so as always, in the description, you'll find links to the stream person I'm on the shared stream yard with. You'll find links to the Petty Fam. You'll find links to Tito and Yato. Tito's funnier than Yato. You'll find Mango's master list of U.S. resources with everything from LGBTQIA+ resources to domestic violence resources to reproductive health resources and beyond. Need help finding a resource? Hit me up. I'll see what I can do to help. There's no guarantees. Pinned at the top is stuff and themes. If you want to help, great. If not, great. It's your fucking money. Do with it as you please. I'm just missing out on some work this week, and it's going to be horrible. Yeah. So. I do not feel good. Alright. Let's say hi to everyone. Let's do the theme and the stuff and the other themes. Hello, hello, Eric Massa. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. Shaw of Thirst. Thank you for acting on orders, Mango. You know what? It was actually really funny because I was already like getting stuff together to pull for today, and then you tagged me in Discord, and I was like, well, it's fantastic fucking time because I need to entertain myself for the next like 3 hours until I have shit to do. So, hooray. Nay, Charizard. Everyone needs to stop saying Shani doesn't eat veggies. She snacks on a baby carrot from time to time. God damn, that was good. That's a good one. I like that one. Hello, hello, Brandon. I love black people, except the black homosexual Freemason devil worshippers. Exactly. That's why she doesn't like drag or G-Man. Or P. Diddy. Which is just a weird combination of people, if you ask me. But everyone should hate P. Diddy. Hello, hello, Knitting Gamer. Good morning, not working today, so I will be here the whole stream. Woo! Awesome! It'll be lovely to have you the whole time. By the way, starting Radiation on Friday, finally. Fuck yeah, Radiation! Oh, I'm so glad that you finally get to start that. I know it's been bothering you that you haven't been able to yet. Hello, Holafola. Oh, Mango, I hope... Thank you. I appreciate that. I feel like shit. Also, I haven't been able to eat since last night, which is probably a good thing, all things considered. Hey, Arxinium, my twin. A small human breathes like an alien. Don't encourage the weird breathing habits. It's not cool. It's not cool. Hello, hello, Billy and Portly. Lovely to see you. I'm off early from work today. Fuck yeah. Greetings, widows. How are you today, bud? Happy Black Hole Sunday. Fuck yeah. Small human doesn't have school because of the eclipse. Also, friendly reminder, if you're in the line of sight of eclipse, and you got eclipse glasses, test them and go purchase another pair or, like, exchange your pair before the eclipse happens, depending on where you're at. Because, like, legitimate eclipse glasses, when you put them on and look through them, the only thing that you should be able to see is the sun. And if you can see everything clearly, then they're fake. Just remember that. Joke's on you, the alien I'm breathing like breathes like a people. Oh, damn. How do aliens breathe, though? I don't know. I'm not sure. Hello, hello, hum along if you can't sing along. It's lovely to have you. I hope you're doing well today. So, I have a nice little collection of things for us to go over. I sound like shit. Why don't we check in with Tony Chase first? Because Tony Chase, it's only about a minute long. We'll check in with Tony. It's always good to make sure that he is okay. Doop 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 doop. Where's the button? There's the button. I found the button. Click. Alright, so this one is titled Charge Government for MK Ultra Terrorism All the Years They Have Been Stealing from Me and My Parents. Short, sweet, to the point title. What's up, Tony Chase?
This is another cat brush I have. Brush my cat with the green one and a Revlon brush. My satellite man's still hitting my cat in the head. They're running their cat around the house while they're, you know, trying to make her get up from where she's laying and making her pace back and forth. The satellite man's going to be prosecuted for home invasion.
Okay. Just right off the bat, it sounds like your cat is doing cat stuff. Getting up, walking around, pacing about. Cats usually do that. But I'm sorry that you think that the satellite man is attacking your cat. Your cat is a very nice-looking kitty cat. Hello, hello, Griffin Doggo. I needed some Tony and Mino. Oh, well, welcome. It's lovely to have you. Also, thank you, Colette, because I got your thingy yesterday, and I appreciate it.
Voyeurism, causing injuries for their with their voyeurism. They need to get prosecuted for their crimes. The fuck are you staring for, man? What are you trying to find? You're harassing.
Maybe the satellite man just like really appreciates your cat. It is a very cute cat. And it's very well taken care of, clearly. She's a chunky, happy cat. And seems to absolutely love you. So maybe the satellite man is jealous that you have a cat that really likes you. Think about that, Tony.
Sing me. What are you trying to find? You've caused injuries and mutilations. What are you staring at, stupid fuck? For that harmful technology. You have to get charged for MK Ultra attempts of murder, too.
You heard him. Oh, hey, satellite man. Dave the intern has been warned about messing with Tony Chase's cat. We'll need to talk to him again. Please do, because Tony Chase's cat is a very good kitty cat. And he is a very good cat owner. We love Tony Chase. Hey, QTC. This dude again? Yeah, I love Tony. Tony is just the best. It's a good kitty. I often do that thing where a kitty yawn and you just poke. Maybe that's what Satellite Man is doing? Maybe. Maybe the kitty cat only gets poked every time it yawns. Hello, hello, Mari. I'm here. How late am I? Not very. This is literally the first video, so you are right on time. Don't worry. So, thank you, Tony. We love Tony. And let's see, what's up next? Let me go back to the introduction part, see how you're doing. I'll be right back. All right, Mari. We'll see you in a minute. All right, so you guys are going to get to choose what we do next. Oh, geez, this guy just stopping by to say hello. I'm at work. Hello, hello, Slim. It's lovely to see you guys. Don't forget, tonight at 5:30 p.m. Eastern, Slim Cyborg is doing stuff over on his channel, as he's wont to do Monday through Thursday. And today's episode is, hold on, Debunking the Matrix was a documentary. Debunking the Matrix was a documentary. So be sure to go and check that out. It's always a fun time. Now, all right, you guys, we've got choices. We can watch Bad Food. Excuse me, we can watch Jessica, or we can watch Shani or Rev. We got Food, Jessica, Shani, Rev. So, you know, pick your poison. Hello, Mistaken Reaper. Hello, everyone. I hope you are all doing well. Just got home from physical therapy. I am glad that you have made it home from physical therapy. I hope that physical therapy was very good today. So while you guys vote on that, y'all can watch Nick Bravo from Mr. Fat Photog.
I do not believe that I actually showed anything of my body that was inappropriate by the standards of good taste. By YouTube's community standards. Now, I do love my body. Other people don't have to love my body. It's not their body, it's mine. and I decided to stay on the show.
Ask me about my wiener!
Seemed to wiener schnitzel, we're all together now. With hamburgers and hot dogs, no more need to look around. Hamburgers and hot dogs, all together now. After wiener schnitzel, it's all together now. After wiener schnitzel.
Thank you for enjoying that. Let's see. We got a Rev. We got a Bad Food. We got Methica. We got two for Rev. Nick, we saw your Corky Porky dick. Yes. Yes, we did. Although, it was small. It was small. Hello, CT. You came in at a very bad time. Hello, hello, user two. Isn't that what the pervs always say? Yes. Yes, it is. Nick Bravo is what Rax would be if Rax wasn't coddled his whole life and didn't have CCD. You're right. You are right about that. Alright, so we have two for Rev, which means that the Revs have it somehow, some way. So we are going to watch Rev first, and then I have a Shanny video. But does he have slack and floppage? He actually has neither. He has neither. Alright, so these are going to be out of order because people want to see Rev high. So this is from the day after the Shanny video we're going to watch. And it's titled Blessed and High. Also, shout out to Drama Clip Dump for this one. This one comes to us from Drama Clip Dump. Hello, I'm back. Sorry about the food poisoning, Mingo. Oh, it happens. Pro tip, if something about the egg seems off, don't put it in your ramen. It's not a good idea. You will have regrets. Hey, Jinyu. Good morning, Mingo and Dr. Small Human Esquire. He is quite the doctor. And he is quite small.
You're cute.
This is riveting, Riv. Why is he sitting there like that? What is the point in sitting there like that? Oh my goodness. Small human. If you're going to play with that, can you take it in there? Thank you. I appreciate it. But why is he covering his eyeball? What's the point? At least they didn't leave plastic in their food like Juice said. Who knows? They might have. Eye test? Maybe? Illuminati crap. That would make sense. He's way too white for that hat. Fun fact. That hat used to have dreadlocks sewn onto it. And they removed the dreadlocks and have just the hat now. Has Dr. Small Human Esquire started preparing legal briefs in your civil suit against the Hill that body checked you? He has begun that process, yes. I myself am also going to have him start up a civil suit against the egg that gave me food poisoning. I have not been able to eat since last night. It's not comfortable.
You okay?
Yeah. Lost in the Abyss. That's a good name. I like that.
That's me.
Are you lost in the abyss, Shannon?
Yeah.
Why don't you describe being lost in the mist, in the abyss, in the mist, in the abyss, in the abyss? Eating a whoopie pie.
You feel nothing.
Eating a whoopie pie. So, for those of you that don't know, Shani is prescribed gabapentin. And people that are prescribed gabapentin because they need gabapentin, it works for them. It does the thing it's supposed to do. But when you are taking gabapentin that you're not supposed to be taking, you end up high as balls if your body chooses to react that way to it. It's one of those things. Some people get the high reaction to it. Some people don't. Some people feel better on it. Like, all bodies are different, but he is high as balls on gabapentin. Hey, Red Eye. For those that don't know, Red Eye makes art. Check out Red Eye's art. Why is Ted Nugent's love child on the screen pretending to be Jack Sparrow? Because he's a professional. Hello, Lisa V. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. What the fuck is a whoopie pie? Is that on your bariatric diet, Shan Shan? A whoopie pie. Okay, let me find a picture of one for you so that you can see it. Because, no, this would not be on her bariatric plan at all, in the least. Oops. Deep, 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 deep. Whoopie pies. They're like, instead of cookies on either side, it's like tiny cakes with cream in the middle. Aren't they cute? They're quite delicious. But they are definitely not something that would be in a bariatric plan. Well, thank you, Mari. I really appreciate that. I will try to relax when I can. Relaxing is not very easy for me as a person. But I will try. I mean, hold on. I gotta update the pin, guys. Deep, 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 deep. Deep, 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 deep. Never heard of a Wookiee pie. Gotta watch out for the Wookiees. They'll get you. They'll get you if you're not careful. Place the pin. Boop. Okay, so. I heard that getting high from it is all in people's head. Oh. Hold on. Deep, deep. Mm-hmm. So, drug effects for gabapentin, they actually, once again, vary on the person that uses it. It is not something that is just, like, in people's heads. Technically, everything is in your head, you know what I'm saying? But it can get some people high. And that is unfortunate. Actually, fun fact. In Kentucky, gabapentin is found in nearly 1 in every 3 overdose deaths. Because people get high off of it and overdose. I was on gabapentin for anxiety. I lost 24 hours of time. That's terrifying. Terrifying. Small Human Esquire is on the job. Yeah, Dr. Small Human Esquire is not very good at his job, but he's doing his best. And he did write Widows a prescription for a blunt. So, strangers in the Stygian, swirling around in 1,000 tons of shanty shit. That sounds awful. GABA doesn't really work for me. Maybe I need to take more. I only tried it a few times from the shops. Like with every prescription, everyone is going to react different. Some people can take it and be fine. Some people will take it and not be fine. When it comes to like ADHD meds, I tried Strattera, but Strattera gave me chronic fatigue. So I had to switch over to something else. Whereas my brother, he could take Strattera just fine and not have any issues. Apparently my body just does not react too well to SSRIs. It is what it is. Hello, hello, Undead Ramen. They look effing gross. Imagine one of the little Debbie oatmeal cakes except with chocolate cake. Ew. I enjoy chocolate cake. I was asked if I wanted to take gabapentin for nerve pain after my second surgery. I was told you can't just stop it, but have to wean yourself off of it. I bet that's why she has so many pain vids. That might be. Because she takes more than prescribed. Yes. Not only does she take more than prescribed, but because she doesn't like regularly see a doctor, she sees multiple doctors at various times. She'll have her prescription. She'll abuse her prescription. And then she's out of her prescription and she has to just stop. And that's not good. It is not good at all.
You feel nothing.
And medicated.
Medicated and feeling nothing. We had somebody that blessed us. And, you know, people are cool. People are really fucking awesome, actually, you know? They are.
May I say gabapentin has been really...
Christ.
I don't know what they did, but they changed something in it.
Gabapentin is really good, folks. Gabapentin is the fucking shit. It actually is. And you know, when I was working at Burger King, there was a really nice individual there. Very nice. Let these fuck.
No, great. More Burger King stories. But I'm thinking that something else that's going on here, because someone blessed them, they probably bought alcohol. And you know, whenever they buy alcohol, there's usually an issue because they will take Shani's prescription meds with the alcohol, which can also just fuck you right the fuck up.
And the white light, get out. Let's, that's better. I like that.
He worked at Burger King? Yes. So, apparently, like back in like October of last year, he worked for Burger King. He claims that he worked there for 2 months. We're thinking that he worked there for 2 weeks. And he claims that he quit. We're thinking that, because the rumor is that he got fired for hygiene, like having terrible hygiene. And I'm thinking that the rumor is more correct than what he claims. But yes, excuse me. He does have like his old Burger King crew hat and everything still. Hello, hello, Fit and Curvy. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. Bless them with soap? No, of course not. There's no blessing with soap. Hello, hello, dog. Oh no, it's Rev. It is Rev. Hey, Jay Gamer. How you doing today? He also said he called out sick for 3 weeks. Yeah, he claimed that he called out sick for 3 weeks, which, no. No. That's not a thing. That's not a scene. Worked at Burger King with his cum fingers. Oh my god, he did say that. I forgot about that. Yes, please go to the corner. Oh my god. How are you feeling? I feel like shit. I feel like shit. Between the hip and the food poisoning from last night, a horrible day. I'm leaning towards rumor too. Yeah. Okay, later. Later, CT.
I was working at Burger King, and there was an individual that worked there, and they were transgender. They were trans. They called them Teddy. Very nice person. And had...
Jesus.
The fuck was that? Oh. Thank you, dog, for gifting 5 memberships. Knitting Gamer, Undead Ramen, Hola Fola, Fit and Curvy, and Lucifer Almighty. Welcome to the Armchair Quarterbacks. Welcome. It's lovely to have you. I should probably do a members thing sometime soon, because there's quite a few of y'all, and it's wonderful. Not the food poisoning. Yeah. Yeah. Again, if something seems off about the egg, don't put it in your ramen. You will regret it. I have regrets. Looks like he's wearing lip gloss. It kind of does. That was a demon. Hold on. Wait. Let's take it back just a tiny bit so we can hear that again. Do not give Lulkhouse anything. They are degens that do not deserve it. Thank you, Charizard. The facts. All the facts. MFAO, he burped, and I was like, what the fuck was that? And 1 second later, you said the same thing. Hey, Two Guns. Lovely to see you. Yeah, you're not trying if you show up for an interview or a job with bad hygiene and dirty clothes. No, you're not trying at all in the least. You're fucking up. That's what you're doing. You're fucking up. Aw. Thanks, Widows. If he was wearing lip gloss, it's a nice color. It is a good color. It is a great color. Hey, Aline Ebony. Are you okay today? Fuck no. I feel like shit. But small humans off school today because of the eclipse. And the only way that, like... He's autistic. He reads my emotions very well. If I'm in a good mood, then typically he's in a good mood. And we kind of balance it out like that. So I slap on a smile and I just keep fucking going. I have personal time that I can take later tonight and like decompress and not be happy. But for right now, we're in a good mood. I'm like the only person I know that notices Lulkhouse clothes and makeup. I like to point out when they're wearing ridiculous shit. Or like with Cobes when he wears the same shirt so many days in a row. And there's a very nice creature on the subreddit that has like this entire spreadsheet of clothing that Cobes wears, like shirts. And how many days in a row he wears them. It's fucking great. I give you so much credit, Mango. You always push through with such a great attitude. Hey, there's nothing else that I can do, so might as well. Might as well. I wonder if the light bulbs are discolored from the smoke, too. He's actually using a ring light. The same ring light that he used when he made that video and he was like addressing Chris in them and like kept switching colors to match his mood because he was speaking for Grace through some shit. So he switched from the bright white to the yellow.
Very nice person. And had...
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that's not a burp. That's a fucking demon. That is a demon.
They have the same health conditions that Shani has. Like, literally. Fibro. Polycystic ovarian disease. And the stretchy skin and the blah, 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 what that weird condition.
Is stretchy skin common with the PCOS? Because I know that stretchy skin is Ehlers-Danlos. I don't know if stretchy skin is part of PCOS. Also, Shani's skin is only stretchy because, you know, she gained a whole bunch of weight. Hello, Red Royals. Howdy doody. How you doing today? Next full eclipse in the UK will be in 2090. I will be 121 years old. I can't wait. Listen, who amongst us hasn't spoken on behalf of Christ? I myself personally have not spoken on the behalf of Christ. But I mean, I'm sure other people have. I have a feeling after the eclipse, everything will calm down and go smoothly for you. I fucking hope so. Mercury is in the Gatorade and the eclipse is happening and there's just too much going on at once. And I should probably take some ibuprofen for my hip, but I am scared of drinking water right now. I have PCOS, skin normal. Good to know. That's good. They're mixing their diseases. They seem to always mix them up. Like, always. I charge Christ by the word so he never has me speak for him. I could have sworn that stretchy skin was a sign of life. Please verify with Dr. Small Human Esquire. Dr. Small Human Esquire. Give me those, please. Thank you. Question, bud. Is stretchy skin a sign of life? I don't know what that meant, but I will take your word for it. I believe Mercury is still doing a live stream for Trans Healthcare. Yes, yes, she is. They're doing it for, oh my gosh, cannot remember the organization's name. But I feel so bad, but yeah, they're still doing that right now. Does she have brown blood, fins on her back, tiny hands? No offense to any carnies that might be lurking. I don't think we have any carnies that are lurking, but we do have a sideshow freak that hangs out in here. His name is Slim. He swallows swords and lets people staple money to him. He's also a blockhead. Pretty fucking dope.
They go to me, hey. I'm prescribed Adderall because I have ADHD. And that's so, you know, I want to be fucking. I apologize to all transgenders. You know what I mean? Because like Nadia, I love Nadia, and I should be in the mode. It's a he. You know what I mean? In this case, it's a trans woman, a trans man. I really apologize because I'm totally pro this stuff. Like everything LGBTQ, I'm for it because it's about love. It's about loving people. You know, what's up, Ashes? You know, it's about love. It's not about, oh, we're going to violate the Bible. You know, yeah.
Don't you want someone to care about you?
Please don't sing, Shanny. I'm already nauseous. You're going to make it worse. I'm pro this stuff. Yeah, exactly. He's pro this stuff. Don't know what he means by this stuff. But didn't seem like that when talking about the Diddy stuff. No. When he was talking about what Diddy done did, he was very much anti-homosexuals. Especially black homosexuals. Just, all of it's odd. It's very odd. Was that singing? For her, yes. She could have been a professional singer and model. Sure. Sure, why not?
Exactly, see? Don't let it slip away. Yay, yay. Love is fucking worth it. You know? These transgender people just want to live their fucking lives and be like happy. You know? And you got these fucking cocksucking piece of shit. Oh, we're Christians.
Like G-Man saying he's going to take a bat on a transgender's head.
Mm-hmm.
And then Carrie supports him.
He did that. He did that. Carrie supports him. What the fuck are you talking about?
She made an excuse for it, man. That's so fucked up.
Wait a minute. What, is Carrie sucking G-Man's fucking cock?
Probably.
Is that for real?
Yeah, man.
Carrie, do you like the BBC?
Oh, man. Oh, okay. So, there are a lot of people on the internet that choose to go the enemy of my enemy is my friend route. You know what I'm saying? And that has nothing to do with sucking dick or liking BBC. Also, how do you know the size of G-Man's? Or are you just working off of stereotypes? Oh. Yes, the BBC channel is quite good. It is quite good. Yes. I like the BBC. They give us a lot of television to watch. I'm getting a note from the producer. I too like BBC, the channel. I do quite enjoy panel shows. And the only people that can do panel shows right are people over, you know, in the UK. There's no one else that can do a good panel show. Especially not over here. We tried. We failed miserably every fucking time. Hello, Vicar Fly. Shanny still loves G-Man. Oh, yeah. She's never going to get over G-Man. His beard matches his teeth. Can I come out of the corner now? Yes. You're more than welcome to come out of the corner. No, Carrie likes the guy who works at Olive Garden. She needs those breadsticks, man. All of the breadsticks. Wow, he's really concerned about Carrie. Keep your eyes on your manlet, Shanny. Ain't nobody important. Can we just ignore these moronic time oysters? But it's stupid morning bullshit. And, or today it's stupid afternoon bullshit. And they're stupid. It's afternoon. And they're full of bullshit. So it works. Rev is still mad he got cucked by G-Man when he lived with them. Nobody clip Mango saying she likes the BBC. You know what, Brandon? You know what? Shanny loves G-Man and Chris more than her actual partner. Oh yeah, she is still way hung up on Chris. Which is awkward and weird. I don't like it. They have so much to bond over, like drunk driving. Oh my god.
Oh. Do you like the BBC, Carrie? Make you scream, not like your
double
wife.
Double penetration.
Ah, dude, that's it.
Why? excuse me. Why do y'all care about what Carrie's doing behind closed doors? Hey, Mo. The eclipse is coming, but is he still proud of his graph? You know what? We have not checked in to see. So, let's find out, shall we?
Look at this graph!
He is very proud of his graph today. Very proud of his graph today. Shanny, who brought that up? Yeah. Shanny brought that up. Why be weird? It's all they have. They have nothing else going on. They're just there's a lot to unpack with this. Do they not like BBC? They should indulge in it. It's a great program. But if someone asks her if it's gray, it's sexual harassment. Not defending Carrie, just calling a spade a spade. Yeah. Excuse me. And that's, like, that's such a common thing. They're massive fucking hypocrites. They're very much rules for thee and not for me. And it's so dumb. The graph and his eyebrows are perfect. They are. They are. Sorry about that. I had to cough. Carrie may like BBC. But does she like
pickles? Pickles. 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 Pickles.
So many pickles, so little time. Excuse me. Oh, also, my darling bestie, Mr. Security Monitor Lizard, sells pickles. And they're fantastic. And you can hit him up at postaliguana@gmail.com to order pickles. The eclipse will also shine down on pickle production. I like the BBC channel, too. I find their documentaries very interesting. Their documentaries are really, really good. We're weird. They're fucked up. There is a difference. Weird is fun and can be freeing. Fucked up can get you 4 to 5 in a padded cell with electroshock therapy. That's a valid point. Come on, human. Please do not that. That's... No, hand that here, please. Be careful. This is the brush for the doggy. Yeah. That's the doggy's brush. We should be able to see part of the eclipse if it wasn't fucking raining. No! Not the rain. It's very clear outside today, and I think where I'm at, it's supposed to be visible right around 3:15 p.m.-ish. So, don't do that. OMFG, children's happy laughter. I love it. Yes, that is Dr. Small Human Esquire. He's in a great mood. Partially because I am hiding all of the pain that I am in. Because he feeds off of that. Yay, autism. I'm back and was gifted a membership. Awesome. Thanks, dog. Yeah, dog is fantastic. Small human. Indoor excitement, please. Thank you. It hasn't stopped raining. We've a storm, but pup are like playing slip and slide in the garden. Oh, that's so cute. I fucking love dogs.
Okay.
Okay, we need to stop. I'm being naughty.
No, sorry. This is awesome.
I am on gabapentin, and it's absolutely driving me crazy right now.
It's gabapentin.
I don't know. They did something to it.
No, somebody blessed us. I'm going to let them know. I don't bug.
I'm burping.
Can we get a little bit of a woo, 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 Snoop Dogg? No, okay.
Sorry, I'm going to take that back one more again. One more again. Yes, Mari, I did. And I have to take it easy because I did slightly pop it out of place, but it is back and it hurts. And I'm tired. I haven't been able to sleep right. So, but it's okay. It's okay. I will be fine. Can't wait to be in the darkness in NYC. Hey, PT Ham. It's going to be great. OMFG, I didn't want to compare your son's laughter to mine, but now I know he's autistic too. So, yes, he sounds exactly like my boy used to when he was younger. I miss that laugh. I fucking love it. He's a goofy goober. Yep. Sounds as if Dr. Small Human Esquire has come up with devastating arguments for the civil suit. Oh, he has. He has. Yeah, the pharmacy cut the gab with Fint. Sure. Yeah, it's fucking ridiculous. Looking ridiculous. Can we get a what, Rev? Don't worry. I'm about to replay it because I wanted to hear that one more again. Just one more again. Gabapentin Kit Kats is a boy. He's a boy, not a racist. Shits in the tub. Yes. Yes. Mango was pop, lock, and drop. Fuck no, I wasn't. I don't have the knees for that woman. I don't have the knees for that. I do not have the knees for that. If I pop, lock, and drop, you're going to have to pick me up off the floor. So what was that, Rev? What, can we get a what?
I don't know.
I'm burping.
Can we get a little bit of a woo, 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 Snoop Dogg? No, okay.
No, you cannot get a whoop, whoop, whoop Snoop Dogg. Who's even offering a whoop, whoop, whoop Snoop Dogg? What is happening? I know. I'm confused. I I am just so confused.
Whatever. Fuck this shit. I'm just gonna play video games. Check this fucking shit out, okay? I don't know what's gonna catch. This is for Mike Matei. All right, I'm gonna tag Mike Matei in this fucking video. I'm gonna tell you right now, Mike, this fucking TV, okay? It's a fucking Vizio. It's got, what do you call it? Fucking, what is it called? It's got component, right? It's got the red, the white, and the fucking yellow in the back of it, right? This thing looks like a fucking CRT, okay? Mike, like for real, I'm with you. I'm with you on flat monitors being shit for classic games.
Can I remind you the battery on the phone is about to die?
Oh, okay. I can't do shit. So I just want to say to Mike Matei really quick that the fucking flat panel Vizios now with the component, it's like having a fucking CRT, Mike. And it's like even clearer. The colors, they did it, dude. This is for Mike.
God, you're manic as fuck.
Oh my God, he's excited about something. Look, he may be high and like going off, but I wouldn't call that him being manic. I would call that him being high and happy. But at the same time, like, why can't you just let the man enjoy his happiness? My parents traveled to Texas to see the eclipse from the Pacific Northwest. As far as I was told, it's cloudy there. Ooh. It's a nice clear day out here. It's actually such a nice day that I've got the front door open with the window up on the screen door. Get nice circulation of air. He's so mad and can't yell at her. I love it. Nope, he sure can't. As Rev received a recent head injury, he seems non-racist and his homophobia has disappeared. Oh, no, it's still there. It is still there. He will always and forever be a piece of shit. It's just, he can't get people blessing them if he is a piece of shit. Like, on Instagram. She forgot what excitement looks like. Anytime he gets really excited about something, she always does this. She tells him to calm down or be quiet. Like, he got excited over Fruity Dino Bites. And she told him to lower his voice, and he was like, okay. Like, it's ridiculous. Ridiculous. Excited about a 10-year-old TV? Yes, he is excited about the 10-year-old TV because he can play his classic video games on it.
I can't do anything, man. I'm just having fun.
Yes, you are. I know.
And you're annoying. You're annoying, right? I'm annoying you. I'm annoying her. And I just got, you know.
You haven't shut up all day.
Okay. So here we go.
It's been a mile a minute all day.
Okay. We had a great day fucking, and I want to use this and eat her out and make her come. See you later, guys.
So I'm going to go be sick real quick and then regroup because I did not need to hear that. I have been nauseous since last night and have not eaten anything. Hello, hello, randomly ignored 84. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. I'm sorry that you showed up at this moment. Why the fuck did we have to see that? Okay, look here, listen. I did not know that that was the ending of this video. I did not vet this video before we watched it. I have this bad habit of doing not that. Yeah. Wait. What? That's the opposite of what I want. Yeah. Yeah, it is. But others aren't allowed to tell her to calm down when she gets excited? No, they're not allowed to. It's illegal. It's against the rules. Well, further proof God is dead. Yeah. I'm making dinner. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Mingo Jones needs to go to video editing school. No. I just... Look here, listen. I have to say, one thing I never understood was she was always complaining about Rev's volume. But when she was with G-Man, she never complained. And G-Man is much louder than Rev. Because she loves G-Man. She wants G-Man. She's always wanted G-Man. Hey, Stang Doll. How did TGR leave that out? I mean, on their part, that was probably a great decision. Not sure if God is dead, but there sure is a trickster spirit that likes to disturb us poor mortals. Yeah, there is. Yeah. I think Shani gets jealous of Rev when the drugs work better for him than her. Ooh. That is a good point. And see, Shani doesn't take into the account the fact that Rev is like an eighth of her body size. So of course the drugs are going to work different for him. Now I'm shouting these facts at my partner. He's not happy. Well, he's welcome. He is welcome. All right, so since we're doing Shani Rev stuff before we do Jessica stuff, why don't we... Hey, hey, Skits. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. I hope you're doing well today. Also, because Skits is here, because Skits is the sponsor of the Stream Pervs, who I'm on the shared stream yard with, we at least need to see this. We love Skits. Skits is good people. Well, I don't know how long you're going to be, but I got to get me some pickles and ginger ale. The only thing that'll make me feel better. I'm going to go get a glass of water, even though it'll probably make me throw up. So, why don't we watch another fat photog while we all take a moment before we watch Shani. Drove 30 hours to Texas for the eclipse and it's a thunderstorm? No! That's horrible, Skits. I know you were so excited about it. I'm sorry. This is how I show love. Want to hear some fucked up shit? I do the same thing to my person. Not my partner. They're my person. They're my best friend. But I do the same thing. So before we get into Shani stuff, we will watch a fat photog. And I will get some water. How about we do Crackin' Cocaine?
It is a great song, man.
Who did that one?
I will cut your tongue out.
Using crack and cocaine to get high. That's what you say you love.
You damn well know I can move my booty meat.
Yeah.
You tell them they're scum of the earth. You say get a job. You're destructive and I'm not.
I'm out of here. I'm divorcing Jason. I'm divorcing you guys. Because you know what? I'm always turned into a bad guy when I'm trying to do and make fucking people happy. Fuck all of you.
Maybe this is what you want. You want me to drop dead. You don't want to help someone who actually needs help, who's helped everyone else. I was giving these people so much fucking money, and now that I don't have any fucking money, it's I'm a scam artist.
But your life is a joke, and you need someone to help you out. Cause nobody's needing that crack and cocaine. There's terrible trouble behind it, and sooner or later you're burning your brain, making a mess of your mind.
Life, I can't even wipe my own fucking ass because...
Moral of the story? Don't always listen to the trolls. They don't know what the fuck they're listening or talking about.
Cause nobody's needing that crack and cocaine. There's terrible trouble behind it. And sooner or later you're burning your brain, making a mess of your mind.
Oh. Alright, and while I get the Shani video set up, courtesy of Mr. Frank Crudea from TGR, we have the Shanley. I fucking love the Shanlets. They make the world go round. My fiance is putting something in our vows about never hearing about Shani and Rev sex. Honestly, that's valid. I respect his decision, but at the same time, where's the fun in that? All right, so this Shani video comes to us from the day before. The Rev video. And let's see. Hold on. Sorry, guys. I was getting some stuff. This is the day before the video of them being high. This one is called I Choose Me. What she is choosing herself for, I don't know. Damn, that is going to be in my head again. I will be humming it all day. Why? Because it's great. Because it's great. Ooh, thank you, Mo. I will have to grab that here in just a little bit. As opposed to what? Or as opposed to who? I don't know. She chooses herself. The Meredith Grey speech. Choose me. Love me. I fucking hated that shit with a burning passion. Look here, listen. I have not watched Grey's Anatomy since like season 7. But that Meredith Grey speech... I wanted to call her an idiot sandwich. Because no.
I want to thank you guys. One love. Thank you. But yeah. I know they ain't gonna stop, and haters are gonna hate because that's all they have to make themselves feel good. I'm just gonna be me. I don't care about the shaming, the hating, the trying to explain my life, even though they don't know who I am. I don't give a shit anymore.
You don't give a shit anymore. So you're going to make a video about how much you don't give a shit. That is what we call illogical. And yeah, while we may not know you in real life, like we've never met you face to face, we know enough about you to come to a very solid decision on the fact that you're a garbage person. You are a garbage person. Is Shani hiring herself out to test out the new MRI machine at her local zoo? Shani can feel shame? I don't think she can. I do not think that is something she is capable of.
You know, I'm at a point in my life where I'm just going to choose me. I'm going to choose my husband. And I'm going to choose my sons and my cats. That's where I am.
Oh, Shani, you got those out of order. See, you're going to choose your boyfriend, not husband. You're going to choose your boyfriend. Then you're going to choose the cats. And then you're going to choose your sons. Because your sons have not been in the picture now for almost 2 years. They've been on a CPS vacation. First it was CPS summer camp, then we went into winter camp. We're actually about to reach our second CPS summer camp. Although technically it's the third. Yeah, it's third CPS summer camp, because it got taken during the summer, and that was one. Then last year, then, yeah. Anyway, I can math. How is she a garbage person? She's not employed. Garbage is too good for Shani. Okay, y'all are both correct in this. Y'all are both right. You're both right. Bitch, your pupils. Hey, Hillbilly Jim. Welcome, welcome. It was just a vacation. Yeah, it was only a vacation. You know? It's just some people take really long vacations, apparently.
You know, like, you want to come to me and say shit things to me, that's like, the only thing that's going to happen is, you know, you get blocked and then maybe I pop off a little. But like, I got better things to do with my life. And there's much more interesting to do on the internet than what I guess you guys do.
So then why are you making this video? Why are you making this video? If you have so many other better things to do, especially on the internet, then why does this video exist? Because if you had other better things to do on the internet, you'd be doing them. I find this fun. This is a hobby. This is actually, like, helping me to not be in my own head about my nausea and my fucking hip. Okay? Like, this is great. This is fun. This is entertaining for me. But once I'm done talking about you, like, I'm gonna go off and do other things that don't involve you. But I'm not going to announce to the entire world, yeah, I have other better things to do right now. I'm just going to go do them. She was such a good parent, the state couldn't handle two well-adjusted children. That's how she makes it seem to the unknowing. Yes, that's exactly how she makes it seem. Do you think she'll ever get them back? No. Well, okay, so I think that she will not get custody back through the state. I think what's going to end up happening is William's going to age out and she is going to try and get him to come back. I think that's what's going to happen. I think she is just waiting for him to age out of the system. Because she's done nothing to help her situation. Her pupils are huge. Am I the only one seeing this? Am I tripping balls? You are not tripping balls. The balls have not been tripped. Ew, well, oh, hold on. To be fair, I don't think anyone wants to come to you in more ways than one. That is fair. That is very fair. A pop off in the UK is a fart, so is Trump. I don't think about Shani outside of streams unless a really funny joke comes to mind. She was too good at parenting. She was so good at parenting. So good. I got things to do too, but I can multitask. Yeah. I would be better at multitasking today if I just feel like shit, so it's very hard for me to keep my mind focused on multiple tasks when I feel like shit. They'll age out and go back if he has nowhere else to go. Yeah. I guess my lupus is flaring up today because all of my joints are aching and I have to finish work. Oh, I'm sorry, randomly ignored 84. I hope that it isn't too terrible today. My best friend since first grade, she also has lupus. And I know that some days are definitely way better than others. And it just kind of, whenever you're having a flare-up, it just kind of creeps up and then bam, it's there. Spoiler alert, I think at the end of this video, she mentions a game called Coral Island. But of course, in Shani fashion, she mispronounced it to Corral Island. How did she get the money for it? Hold on, let me look it up. Coral Island. God damn. Yeah, who's giving her $30 for fucking Coral Island? Not to mention, like, any DLCs and shit she wants to get. Fuck that. Who? I'm betting someone blessed her with money for food and she opted to not that. Hold on. And just bought a video game. If he needs a conservator, she won't be able to get him. The state's case is too strong. Yeah, the state has a very strong case. No, don't forget your Lidl. Hold on. Of course, you can have a Lidl. Did CPS get jealous of her immaculate parenting skills? Yes. Yes, they did. I'm honestly waiting for her to finally say CPS wanted to traffic me as a kid and I outsmarted them and are angry I'm such a model parent taking my kids for no reason was their revenge. That would be fucking hilarious. That would be goddamn hilarious. Jason had just bragged about buying something he didn't need. Like, if... Why? Like... So much unnecessary shit gets bought by them. Like, quit giving them money so that they can buy video games and fucking alcohol and shit. They very clearly know where the food bank is. So they can get food just fine. They're doing nothing to help themselves. Just like, ugh. The pay piggies, when it comes to them, annoy me so bad. They annoy me so bad. Pay piggies gonna pay. Yeah, they sure are. Someone could have just bought the code and sent it to her, or it's a cracked version. I don't think she knows how to download cracked versions. She is not wise. Hold on, sorry guys. Sorry about that. I have a lot going on at once. If the people learn how Shani and Rev raise their children, they'll undo our evil network of evil things we do. Steal those kids. I mean, we all need fishnets to survive, right? Maybe Jason can use them as Revelina. She just needs the 8XL fishnet bodysuit to survive. Yes, fishnets, fishnets, fishnets. You got it, Brandon. You get it. Learning how to install cracked games was the first thing I learned when I finally got a PC. I used to treat them like demos before buying the actual game. I've done that too. Except for Diner Dash. Except for Diner Dash. I'd fucking love me some Diner Dash. Everyone needs Diner Dash in their life. Anyway, let's continue on.
Haters. You haters, debaters. You're just dumb. And... the more time goes on, the more dumb you look. You know, I'm not worried about anything. I'm not worried about death. I'm not worried about life. I'm not worried about my loved ones because I know ultimately God's got this shit. I know, ultimately, God is my avenger.
Well, he's not doing a very good job of avenging you now, is he? Also, what makes you think that God cares for you the most? Because you act like God cares for you the most, and there are so many people that feel that way, and it doesn't make any sense. You're not God's favorite. Scammy needs freedom religion. She does. Where's Vaughn? He can recruit her into it. It'll be great.
I know ultimately that everything that happens to me is under God's will. Because see, I'm being still, you know, and I'm waiting on him. And whatever I need, I ask, and he gives.
Oh, whatever you need, you ask, and he gives. So you asked to have two divorces. You asked that your first husband never paid child support. You asked to burn through all of Rev's money and get evicted. You asked for your kids to get taken away. You asked for Rev to get arrested for allegedly kicking your child. You asked for him to let Rev send his dick pics to Facebook bots and get pictures from Ashley from Norway. Good to know that you requested all of this stuff. Because, hey, you asked for it. Well, she's God's daughter. Hey, is that like the group Shakespeare's Sister? I mean, she's big enough for a few women. This might be a clue. I wish I had the clip of the Hardly Brothers or the Hardly Boys from fucking South Park. Talking about their raging clues. Shani is the bounce house god made up of leftover bits. Do you think she's always sniffing because she's allergic to herself? Also, that rash is coming back on her forehead. Oh my god. I've been waiting for the forehead rash to return. But she might be allergic to herself. She might be. From the outside, God must really hate her then. Sounds more like an entity that punishes more than rewards. She's asked for it all. Did she ask for the crinkle heart? Yes. And the fibro, and to develop cystic fibrosis when she was 19. And all of the other things that are allegedly wrong with her. I know.
It's a fact. It's a scientific fact, okay? You know how you examine something and you repeat it a bunch of times to know that there's a scientific conclusion on something? Like the scientific method, you know, that thingy. I kind of did that with God and it worked. So it's like God is scientific facts. You could do it too, but you know, you have to listen to what the Bible says and you kind of have to pray the way he tells you to. And
oh. So she asked to be sex trafficked by her own logic. Yes. By her own logic. Yes. That's a very good point there, randomly ignored. I didn't even think about that. But yeah. Here's a few sins from the good book, Shani. Wearing polyblend clothes, eating shellfish, and wearing torn clothes. But continue on how the trolls don't know shit. Yes. Also, you're not supposed to add any extra holes to your body that weren't there before. Like, you know, that nose ring she has. You're also not supposed to mark up your skin in a permanent manner, like the tattoos that she has, which, you know, logic or something. She really looks like the Kung Fu Hustle villain now. Drag was right with that comparison. I was going to say the sex traffic thing about what she said happened at 16, but feels too icky. See, I was thinking more so towards the stuff she was saying with drag and G-Man. That's what I was thinking more towards. Shani looks more like Pizza the Hut. Oh, there used to be an entire like Pizza the Hut song thing that we used to sing when I was a kid. I can't remember it for the life of me, but it was dumb as shit.
You know, you kind of have to, you know, try your best not to do horrible things to people for that to work, because I don't know, like.
So, underfeeding your kids, verbally abusing them, allowing your partner to verbally abuse them, ignoring them, full on neglecting them, letting them live in filth and squalor. That's all cool, right? By your words and your logic, that's cool, right? Okay.
All your wishes and all you want, all your wants are based on only you, you know. You don't have, like, the creator of the universe, like, having your back and really serving you. Like, he's the servant king, and he does serve those who love him. He does. So in gratefulness of him serving me, I serve others, and I serve him by giving out his glorious message that he's real, he's here, he sees everything. So sinning's not really a good idea when, you know, you got cameras all on you all the time. You know what I mean?
Maybe you should listen and follow the words that you're saying. Like, what? I do not understand. I am confuzzled. Wonder if Shani's god is black because suddenly he's a servant. Oh, damn. He serves sick dance moves. I heard that he can get down. Aren't we supposed to serve God? You would think that. You would think that that's what we're supposed to do. But God has cameras but doesn't need them because you're on camera all the time. Yeah, she does it to herself. Alright, Shani's pissing me off. So what we're going to do is we're going to watch the trailer for Ribs. And we're going to watch a Fat Photog edit of Miss Naked and Laughing, a.k.a. Queen Cobra, a.k.a. Jessica. Also, I hate doing shit like this, but pinned at the top is me and Small Human Stuff. So if you want to help, great. Be much appreciated. Hey, Sydney. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. I hope you're doing well today. I also need to go grab more water. So that did not stay down. All right. Hang on, guys.
The ribs are pre-cooked. They're not fully done because we're going to pull them out of the oven.
I would literally chop your head off and nobody would be none the wiser. Oh, this is what you really look like? Oh, I'm off with my head.
What does him not fucking like me have to do anything with him, you fucking whore? You broke the fucking code, yeah.
What did I fucking do?
If he don't want to finish his ribs, that's his problem.
Oh.
He better not get this rib sauce on his pants, god damn it. Alright, alright. Would you guys like to see sauce on my pants before we watch the Jessica video? I do have it. We can watch sauce on the pants. We can have a little dance break. Would you guys like sauce on the pants? God damn it. You know what would stay down? Mountain Dew and meth. Lidl. Hold on. Doot, 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 doot.
Lidl, Lidl, Lidl.
I got you, nobody important. All right, so people want the dance break. Mint helps with nausea if you add it to water. Does it help with food poisoning nausea? Because I kind of fucked myself over last night. All right. Time for a tiny dance break.
Woo! Okay, that condom fucking reeks.
Say, I got sauce in my pants, god damn it. 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 Got sauce in my pants. Say, I got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants.
I tell ya.
Well, say, I got pants. Say, I got
sauce.
You know, I got pants. You know, I got sauce. Got sauce in my pants. Got sauce in my pants. You know, I got sauce in my pants.
Some of this
sauce in my pants. Son of a bitch. Sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants. Say, I got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it.
Got some of this, got some of this, got some of this, got some of this sauce.
Sauce. Pants. Pants.
Sauce.
Pants. Pants.
Sauce.
Pants.
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 Sauce.
Pants. Pants.
Sauce.
Sauce.
He's got sauce on his pants. God damn it. Hello, hello, Trisette. Hey, y'all. Sorry I'm late. Just got back from the doctors. What did I miss? Rev thinks that Carrie likes BBC and something about double penetration with G-Man. That was weird. Tony Chase is going to sue because they keep lasering his cat. They've got to stop. The satellite man said that he would talk to the intern, Brian, but we'll see what happens with that. And Shani said that God does everything for her, and everything that has happened to her, she has asked for, which just comes off really bad when you look at everything that has happened to her. It's fantastic. Howdy, howdy, brainless. What are you doing, my friend? I'm dying. I am dying. Once again, friendly reminder to all of the people. If something seems off about the egg, don't put it in your ramen. You will regret it. I feel awful. Mano, can you just not die for 5 minutes? No. No. All Rev penetrated was a fold. Yes. That is true. Always have fresh eggs on ramen. Oh, I know this, but it seemed fine. Yes, I do randomly ignore 84. I actually, oddly enough, have a culinary degree. I did the egg and water test, but something just still seemed kind of off about the egg. It's a duck egg. And I used it anyway, and yeah. It made me violently ill, and I have not been able to eat anything or keep water down that well. So, hi, Yami. Lovely to see you. Yeah, that it was rough. I know, bud. I done fucked up. I'm aware. My goodness. All right, so this comes to us from the one, the only, the rad Fat Photog. So let's get into it.
Yeah, well, I need a new laptop, period. Like, if someone was able to buy Jessica Meska a laptop, and she prayed about it with her evil demonic ways, if she was able to pray about it, then I can pray about it, too. And I'll pray that someone will buy me a new laptop. So, I don't like being rushed. I mean, if people want to keep talking about it, then they should buy it for me. I don't like being rushed. I was going to plan on buying my own when I get over being sick and I get a job. Like, I don't like being rushed like that. People are not donating to me like you think they are.
Who's rushing you to buy a new laptop? Who's rushing you to buy a new laptop? It sounds like you're trying to rush people into donating so that you can get a new laptop. You know what I have not done with the money that's ever been given to me? Buy something like a laptop. I've bought food and small human meds and pull-ups and things of that nature. Because a little laptop that could but can't, it's trying. It's chugging along. And I'm sure your laptop is chugging along just fine for right now. It's one of those things that isn't a necessary expense. My sinuses are really bad. Doctor gave me some meds to help with side effects of quitting smoking. And I have an appointment with ENT doctor to help the rest of the way. Yay to quitting again. Yay! I'm glad that you were able to see someone about that and get the right referrals and everything. Fantastic. And I wish you all the best in that quitting again journey. Ma'am, you're 40. I don't know if I'm praying for a new laptop is the best way for you to deal with things. Oh, I think she was talking about Jessica Messica. Because Jessica Messica, people donated for her to get a new computer. And I think she's making fun of her, talking about how like Jessica Messica prayed about it and shit. Last time I had food poisoning, I sipped Pedialyte or ginger tea with honey. Ooh. I think I have... Yeah, I have a Pedialyte freezer pops. The eclipse is starting and Brother Shaw called Mama Shaw stuttering up a storm like he did last time. I've still got, like, an hour and 15 minutes before it's supposed to be visible where I'm at. It's fucking great. At least I think so. Hold on. Do-do-do-do-do. Yeah. The peak for me is around 3:15. Cool. I was right. All right. Is Jessica Messica a lolcow? I don't know. I don't really follow Jessica Messica. I know that she's been... She's known and been fucking with Naked and Laughing for a long while. But I do not know very much about Jessica Messica. So... Okay, I changed my answer. Pray to the Cobra Demons for a laptop. That's most definitely what's up. That is most definitely what's up.
People don't need to Josh because they love Josh. I want Josh. Well, some people want Josh.
Oh, why'd my internet dip like that? That was weird. Okay, so yes, there are people that absolutely do appreciate and enjoy Copes. There's a lot of people that donate because, well, they can fuck with them with money. And it's funny. It's their money. They can do with it what they want. So. Ah! Hey, GK. Messica isn't a lolcow, she just covers them. Good to know, thank you. I was unsure. Also, I hope you're doing well today. I'll see, I don't know, I would have to do some research. It's better than live TV, in my opinion. Oh, yeah, no, I was having this conversation last night with someone. Because, I was explaining some of the things going on. It's like, this is so much better than, like, reality TV, because, as we all know, reality TV, to a degree, is scripted. Yes. But you can't write some of the shit that actually comes out of the mouths of other people. Like, especially the cows. Like, you can't script that shit. It's fucking hilarious. Someone is going to donate a laptop and put in a program that they have access to it 100% of the time. Oh, for sure. Someone would be crazy enough to do that. My internet was crazy this morning. People here going crazy over the eclipse. Oh, yeah. People are going absolutely nuts over the eclipse here. There were some hotels that are, like, not very good that were selling rooms for, like, $200. When usually they only sell for like 50, 55. It was insanity. And it still is insanity. And traffic is going to be horrible. I never understood why people follow reality TV, but this right here, this is real trash. And real trash is hard to look away from. I like reality TV when it comes from, like, Zeus Network. Zeus Network is cool. I mean, they're horrible people. Like, everyone involved in Zeus Network is an absolutely horrible person. But that's because, like, they actually do real borderline and probably illegal shit. The regular reality TV? Eh. This? Fucking hilarious. This is why I'm glad I live in a small town in the mountains. No traffic except for Deep Creek. Hey, there you go. I'm good. I'll watch from Florida. Our net has been slow, and we're even closing down a bit to see it from work. Oh, awesome. That is fantastic. It's insane. It's just another day, seriously. Last time we had one person get killed, I don't understand. Wow. Like, I understand why this one is super important. This one, we're not going to see another one in our lifetime. So, and it's a total eclipse. But otherwise, yeah. I used to live in a trash neighborhood. I'm glad I moved, but this bullshit fills the void. Catch you guys later. Needs to go to the store. Well, I hope you enjoy your shopping trip there, dog. I, too, need to get some groceries at some point. For the small human. Hooray. Whenever this shit happens in Ireland, we never see it. It's always raining. It's fine. I'll probably leave work soon. No crime waves, please. We'll try.
I should have a girlfriend, but a lot of them don't. A lot of them fucking hate me. Like, you don't understand.
Damn it, Charizard.
I don't expect... I know there's some nice people out there that want me to move out there, and it's very sweet and stuff, but it's also just kind of like... You know... fantasy, really, because it's people don't like me, so, and they didn't like me even before I met him, so if they didn't like me then, they were never gonna fucking like me, so.
But why does that matter? Why does it matter what his fans think of you? Eclipse spoiler, she chooses Edward. Did I do the joke right? Yes, you did. I'm not even going to attempt getting groceries today. I had a hard time getting home from the doctor's. It's crazy. I need to make sure that Small Human has food and stuff. I kind of have no choice in this matter. But, Jessica, can I call you Jessica? Jessica. Dumb bitch, can I call you dumb bitch? Let's go with dumb bitch. People don't have to like you for you to like the person that you like. Also, you were the one that wanted to move out there. You kept saying that you want to move out there. What? Why do you care what his fans and trolls think of you?
It's like, okay, whatever. So I don't expect it. Well, they'll never take it away. And I know why Josh is so worried about that, because I see how freaking low these subhuman scum go. So I see how low they go, and they don't stop either. But I mean, it's like a nice thought and stuff, but I can't even have a GoFundMe because of these fucking assholes. So...
You can have a GoFundMe all you want, but what you were raising funds for was stupid? That's the word, stupid. Like, Jesus Christ. I'm sorry, you guys. She's so whiny. She is so whiny. Why is she so whiny? I should have phrased that differently there, Lucifer. A total solar eclipse that'll be visible where I am at won't happen again in my lifetime. Better. Because while they happen about every 1 to 3 years, where the path is always varies, and who gets to see it where always varies, and where I am at, it's not going to happen again in my location. My oldest daughter's bio dad's parents never liked me. No reason why. Yeah, some people just don't like other people. They just choose to be hateful. I don't like Jessica because, well, first of all, she's whiny. Secondly, she's a bitch. Like, oh my god. She thinks his trolls will make him dump her, except he's trying to own the trolls by staying with her. Trying to own the trolls. Yeah. Like I said, they happen every 1 to 3 years, but the path in which it's at always changes. I want to whine and be super entitled for a second. My hips hurt. My back hurts. My ovaries hurt. When, hey, don't you make jokes about hips, man. I fell down a hill and busted mine. Fuck you. Let me be whiny, damn it.
When people want me to do that so they can help me, you know, it's a really nice thought and stuff, but it's like, well, that's up to him if he wants to send me one. I'm not gonna tell him to. I can't have a GoFundMe because of his fucking trolls. I don't know what the fuck they did, but they got my shit banned, but yet people are allowed to make fake GoFundMes to try and hurt me and troll and bullshit, and that's okay. There's no TOS for that. Like, make it make sense. Like, I literally can't make one for the rest of my life because of these assholes. So I hope they never fucking need anything in their fucking lives and someone comes stomping in on them. And a lot of them are...
Fat Photog, did you really have to zoom in on her sipping? Did you have to? Damn it, Photog. That's not how that works. Wait, hold on. Hold on. Where is it? It's right underneath word salad. There it is.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.
It's not how any of this works. It's just not how it works. I fell while walking to work in the last ice storm, got a huge bruise on my hip, and laughed at by passersby. Great morale booster. People suck. People do suck. People are the worst. The random zooms make it like watching her stream with the taps. Yes! And she's just smacking her fucking phone and everything's zooming in randomly. And then she wonders why it doesn't work. Why is it broken? Bitch, because you were fucking attacking your phone. I could complain about my damn arthritis, diabetes, and my allergies acting up. I hate this weather. But do I? Oh, wait. I think I just did. Well, give me monies and I won't again. I'm inclined to believe she beat the laptop, too. Oh, for sure. She most definitely did. How is she gross even sipping drinks? Because she's just, she's a disgusting person.
Guys with dead, soulless, sociopathic eyes. It's really fucking scary. Really scary. Yeah, exactly, logical bystander. Oh, but people want to believe the scams and actually $2,500 would have been a perfect fucking amount, honestly. It would have been a perfect amount.
$2,500 for what? $2,500 for fucking what? What all were... Huh? I do not understand. I think $2,500 for her GoFundMe to see Josh. Oh, how is that the perfect amount? Does she plan on staying in like the nicest hotel in Casper? If you plan out far enough in advance and use the right websites and stuff, you can fly pretty cheap. You can fly pretty fucking cheap. When me and Small Human made our move, it cost $360 for the both of us to fly to the state that we're in. And that's together. That's not individual price. It's not $360 each. It was $360 total. Jessica, I say this as lovingly as I can muster. You are not worth $2,500. No, she is not. A laptop that can survive her is very expensive. Also true. Prenatals, guys. Oh, yes, the prenatals. Of course. Nicest hotel in Casper is at least $56 a night.
Probably more so for the, because I stayed a little bit longer the second time. And because Aaron let me use his car. So we definitely could have done a lot more, spent a lot more money and yeah, done a lot more things. Yeah, I definitely think $2,500. You know, like I said, it's nice that people want to like help me to move there, but I don't know how they're going to do that. And like I said, people love Josh, but they don't like me, so...
Really? I wonder why people don't like you. I wonder. It couldn't be anything obvious, but you know. Also, thank you, Josette. We really appreciate that. Hang on, let me do the theme. Do 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 do. Deep. Deep. Gotta update stuff. No, if you would cooperate with me, laptop, that would be fantastic. Aha. All done, guys. Sorry. I'm trying my best. So many people starting Eclipse streams. I've still got an hour before it hits here, so I'm just going to chill and do this. Is she not drunk here? Is she acting sober? She appears to be semi-sober, at least. At least. Oh, I got your user too. Hang on.
Oh, to be fair.
I may not have glasses on, but I'm not fucking retarded.
I just had to explain to my lead what an eclipse was. She just turned 21. It made me curl on the floor in nerd heartbreak. Oh, I'm sorry, Yami. I got NASA on in a different tab. Ooh. Nice.
You people act like technology is at the tip of your dick.
At one point, I was young, and it was.
Bitch, you're still young. You're 10 years younger than me, you Demogorgon whore. And even Josh is a few years older than you, and Josh is still a young fucking man. So, bitch,
I'm young.
Don't make me cop you in the fucking
Jessica,
mouth.
Please calm down.
Baby, I'm not going to pop your friend. I'm joking, Joshy.
Okay, Wichikuzu, please stop streaming for a hot minute. It's late.
I will quit streaming here in a little bit.
He just wants her to stop screaming because it's late. That's a fair request. Also, she is being, like, really hype. She looks like so many addicts that live around me. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. You know, whatever. Yes, we had our fights, but you guys don't know everything. And the shit was not supposed to be, the fights were not supposed to be streamed. That's the thing. People act like it was meant to be.
It's not on mute. I don't fucking care. Tell a fuck.
I don't care because it's unnecessary.
I don't care.
Ask me to please quit.
I'm asking you to stop.
Man. She's just trying to gaslight everyone. Because, yeah, you definitely meant for that to be streamed. It just didn't go the way that you wanted it to go. Because, well, everyone saw you as the villain. Because you, in that scenario, were indeed a goddamn villain. Hello. Now, is it pronounced Peridot or Peridot? Leo Peridot? But hello. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. I hope you are having a fantastic day. But yeah, you definitely meant to stream that shit on purpose. Like, you... It's starting to get a little darker here. Not really dark, but more like there's a smoky haze in the sky, like when they do controlled burns in the national forest near where I live. Ooh. It's nuts to me that she thinks that people who are watching this can't tell that she's not a great person. Neither her nor Josh are good at keeping up the illusion. No. Like, and at least when it comes to a lot of his faults, Josh wears it on his sleeve. We know that he is not a fan of trans people. We know that he's a transphobe. We're aware of that. He is not shy about that. But she wants all of us to think that, like, it was such an accident. The fights weren't supposed to happen, you guys. She's fine. She's a good person. Wait, is that fight performance art? Yes. Absolutely.
There was only one where I meant to stream, and that was the sleeping one. Where I was sleeping in the living room. But the other ones were not meant to. They were just forgot about, and they should have been shut off. But no. You know, next time, none of that shit is going to be happening. So definitely pre-recorded sounds the best freaking way to go all the way. For no fucking harassment whatsoever. So, oh my god.
Oh, for those that missed what it said, someone put in the chat, he just got a $2,000 donation on PayPal. Mango, I saw the egg and I made a calculated decision. Did I mention I'm bad at math? I am bad at math. Well, actually, I'm very good at math. Just last night, I was not good at math, and thinking about that egg is actually making me nauseous again. I'm very tired and very weak today. Great at meth, though. Naked and laughing is domestic delight. She is a domestic delight, let me tell you. Who's Cobes? Oh, I want to cry. Her chat can get interesting sometimes.
Okay, people. I don't need to hear about his donations and stuff. All right, I'm
going to
get ready to go here in a second.
I'm going to form their own fucking opinions about Jessica based off of what everyone else has fucking said, and that's what's so toxic about the internet. Is you don't want to get to know the person, you know what I'm saying?
Why do you guys keep saying that? Is she aggressive, Josh?
No, she's not aggressive.
Why do they keep saying that?
I have no idea, because when she was drunk, she was like pushing me and smacking me with them.
Did you get into a fight, like physical?
This thing right here, the puff toy. No, we didn't get into a fight. We resolved it like mature adults.
Okay.
She's not aggressive.
Okay.
Like, what are you going to call how are you going to define aggressive? Like this versus.
Thank you, PayPal person. That's a legal name, so. But I appreciate that. We all appreciate you. Thank you. Let me do the thing. That's the thing. My partner asked me, have you heard of Daniel Larson? My sweet summer child. Yeah, definitely a sweet summer child. Because, oh boy, Daniel Larson. Daniel fucking Larson. It's President Daniel Larson. Oh, he's president now. try those Pedialyte popsicles. I know the Pedialyte really helped me. I will. Once I'm off of here, like, I will definitely have one or three. She cornered you in the kitchen and mentioned beheading someone with an $8 machete tubes. Yeah, but she's totally not aggressive. Oh my god. Yeah, she's totally not aggressive. She would never be aggressive. She has no reason to be aggressive, you guys. Duh. Okay, I woke up with that song. Hi, Mari. She isn't aggressive. That's why I'm scared of that cunt. Mango doesn't want to suck on stream. You know what? No, I don't. I mean, I would for money. But wait, no, that's okay. That's bad. That's I should quit talking now.
This is, you know what I'm saying? No, people don't know the whole story, they don't need to know the whole story.
Oh, please, Josh, don't want fucking gothy, bitch. Yes, I love my ring. I fucking love my ring from Josh. I've never had a man buy me jewelry in my life.
But this is something that, like, is on the internet, though. How'd that happen? Why was that? Why is that online?
Were because you streaming? Because Jessica recorded a stream.
Oh, was she streaming?
Was privated, then she deleted the stream, and the shit got
okay, so she was streaming it, not you, yes. Right?
No. I was not streaming it.
Because you're respectful and you wouldn't stream that shit to the internet. But did she?
Trust me, I know what they're doing. I don't care how long he's known her. I know what's going on. You do not say you're Josh's friend and then try to get some bitch who I can't stand, who's literally been trying to panel with Josh for months now, and Josh knows this. It's not no brand new information. So Jessica's taking it upon herself. Oh, well, Josh and Courtney are friends, so I'm going to try to weasel my... No. No, you're not.
So here's the thing.
Man. Jessica, naked and laughing, is just anti-anyone that wants to talk to Cobes. Like, I can understand why Jessica Mesko wants to talk to Cobes. But Cobes isn't the type of person that you can just, like, force your way into paneling with him. You have to ease yourself into that. Because he does not like trolls. My grandma used to tell us when we said we are bad at math, she would commonly say, "Sweet child, you're just stupid." How much are you going to charge, Mano? Oh my god. Look here, listen, user two, that was a slip of the tongue. I just want to finish out my goal for the day. That's all I want to do. That's all I want to do. I'm not going to say that. When you get off here, put a cool rag on your neck? Yes, I will absolutely do that. Absolutely. Jessica Mesko wants to talk to Aaron, not Cobes. Oh, I don't see the point in talking to Arian Aaron. Nazi Nick. Because, like, he's... Look here, listen. When it comes to Aaron, like, he got himself banned from the Cobes subreddit. How do you go and get yourself banned from the Cobes subreddit? Also, he's well aware of the fact that Jessica didn't have a license and let her drive his car. And it's just not... He's not good people. Hello, hello, Toodle Pants. Welcome in. I hope you're having a wonderful day. That's what a sex worker friend said to me once. Words to live by. Yeah, Aaron is a damn mess. Like, Jesus. Yeah, I'm proud of Josette for getting serious about quitting again. She's got this.
Gosh, okay, listen to me. I don't know Girl World people. I don't just know Jessica Muska.
I don't know who these people are either. All I know is that my girlfriend don't like them, and that makes me go, I don't like them, you know?
Okay, that I agree with that. Like, you trust her, you trust her opinions. I'm just saying that there's always, like, other sides to shit.
My name is Jessica, and there's also a Jessica Muska who's like a 500-pound obese bitch. Looks like she's got Graves' disease, her eyes popping out her fucking head. She's a piece of shit. Oh, women supporting women? Oh, yeah. How do you feel about her telling to kill myself? I'll wait. I'm not 40, you fucking retard. Oh, you didn't send $200 to fucking Josh. How about you shut the fuck up?
God damn. There's so much anger there for no reason. Well, I guess there's a little bit of reason. Reason being that, like, you know, people can be annoying. But you're allowing people to get under your skin. You're allowing people to get under your skin. And that's your biggest problem.
No, I don't know Crystal. And I don't know Crystal, the one that talks major shit and then always gets unblocked on my channel. No, I don't know her. Is that the same one that texted Josh and I read the fucking text? I hope not, because her name was spelled the same way, K-R. I hope that wasn't the same Crystal that I read that fucking text that she sent to Josh. That one? The one that pretends? Okay, yeah, that one? Yeah, I don't like her. I try to block her every fucking time, and somehow she keeps coming back. And I saw the message she sent to Josh. I'm not stupid. No, my plans are cleaning. After I clean my fucking PTA, you know what a PTA is, and this ain't a PTA meeting, baby doll.
PTA? What? Pain in the ass? Is that what you mean? After you clean the pain in the ass, you're gonna clean? What? She's going really crazy at Jessica Muska. She even brought up her kids. That is sick. Yeah, no, leave kids out of it. Like, always, always leave kids out of it. I don't see the point in bringing up kids or family that are not associated with the shit that you do online. I am not a fan of that. Pussy, tits, and ass? Maybe. Maybe. Her method of cleaning is oddly specific, that she only rubs the same invisible spot on the counter for hours. Yeah. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on, you guys. Just 1 second. Sorry, I had to respond to a message. Serious question, Mano. Are you a fan of Hills? No. No, I am not. Pussy that's abominable, which I think Jessica has. Thought she had the Baconator Burgosi. Oh, also, all of this right here, she has bathtub crayons. She has crayons that she uses to draw in the bathtub. Which is, like, small human has bathtub crayons. But he's 10.
After I clean my PTA, I'm gonna go clean the bathroom. It's 2 hours lying.
Oh, why did my Wi-Fi just drop very hard? What is PTA? I think that whoever said it was right. The pussy tits ass. It was Griffin Doggo. I think Griffin Doggo was correct. I think Griffin Doggo was right on that. Is it Baconator cooked, uncooked, or been in the garbage for about 5 weeks? Yes. I'm convinced she sits in an empty tub with the water running. I think she has sat in an empty tub with the water running before. Depending on what type of tub it is and how the drain is, what she also might do is have the drain just barely open so that, like, she has water in the tub and it's seeping out so slowly that leaving the water running just keeps it at, like, an even level. Are there bathtub markers? I actually think there are. I think there are. I feel like bathtub dry erase markers would be easier, Jessica. They would be. Bathtub dry erase markers would definitely be easier. So my work has a merch store, and I got a cardigan. It's so fucking nice. Fuck yeah, cardigans. Fuck yeah, cardigans. I need a cardigan. If she needs that much water, she has to be a water beast. PTA is pits, tits, ass. It's referring to lot lizard bathing etiquette. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. I haven't thought about the pits, tits, and ass washing method in years. Just like, the last time that I ever used that, because we would just call them hoe baths. Last time I did that, I was in college. And you would, after like a night out, you would hit one of those before you go to a class the next morning. But we were always smart enough to make sure that our culinary uniforms were ironed and starched the night before. So that way we could do pits, tits, ass, and put on our culinary uniform and, like, run. I'm just feeling very melancholy today. This has always been a lovely chat with lovely people. Well, I'm so glad that you enjoy this chat, Mari. We absolutely love having you here. You're phenomenal. Such a kind person all the time. bathtub crayons, if I had those in my own place, I'd mainly be drawing and writing memes. Hey, sometimes you just gotta color in the tub. Here's what it is. Last time I did a whore's bath, I did the George Carlin method of armpits, assholes, crotch, and teeth. The Carlin method is a good method. I will give you that. Carlin method is a good method. Oh, hold on.
To be fair.
When you're super exhausted, PTA is better than nothing. Oh, excuse me. Oh my god. Yes, you're absolutely right. You're 100% correct. Pit Sit's ass, way better than nothing. Way better than nothing. Save a lot of time if you use one brush.
Oh. Lee, 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 Lee.
I thought that was just the military shower before getting called an ass clown. Yummy. Well, hello, hello, cats and lady. I hope that you are doing quite well today. It's lovely to have you. For a guy, would that be PBA? Yeah, that would be PBA. Pitts balls ass. That tracks. That reminds me, a large pumice stone and lava soap are on my shopping list. Ooh. Right now on my shopping list is, comfort snacks for small human. Stuff that I can easily cook without, like, having to stand for a long period of time. To, like, help with my hip and everything. Conditioner, because I need conditioner. And... yeah, just basically things that'll help make life... I should probably put, like, broth on there for myself. It's just stuff to make life easier at the moment. Crayola makes bathtub paint. Do what you will with this info. That is good info to have. Fresh eggs? No, I am avoiding eggs for a little while. I am definitely avoiding eggs for a bit. The thought of eggs is gross right now.
I used to work with this lady at Kmart. She was from Boston originally, never drove in her life. She worked at Kmart, so sweet. She would either, like, I think walk home or, like, get a, I don't know. But I had a car, so if I could give her rides home, I would give her rides home. Her daughter loved me so much the way I treated her mother that she gave me a car for free. And at first I refused it because... I was a shallow, stupid bitch. And then, like, 2 weeks later, I literally changed my mind very quick. And now, did the card last me that long? No. It lasted me as long as it needed to last me. But the fact that I cared for her mother so much that she appreciated that.
What the fuck are you on about? Girl, why are we crying? I don't know. Huh? Yeah. In Shaw's words, X to doubt. Massive X to doubt. Bitch, you lying. Look here, listen. My my brain is already kind of scrambled between being sick and dealing with my hip. Okay, my brain is scrambled. But the fact that, like, I'm sure I wouldn't be able to follow this even if I weren't dealing with shit. Wait, was this Naked and Laughing? My brain is wonky. Yes, this is Naked and Laughing. Mango's brain is scrambled eggs. Scrambled brain, eggs, get it? So your brain is scrambled, was the egg as well? You know what, you guys? Yes, the egg was scrambled. The egg was scrambled. Now I'm sad.
She gave me a free corn. I didn't even want to take it at first because I was just like, ew, I don't want to be senior. And I changed my mind really quick. I don't care if it gets you to point A to point B. I don't fucking care. It's what's on the inside that matters. And just the fact that she loved that I treated her mother so kindly meant so much to me. Because I didn't want her mother walking home and stuff. I would give her a ride anytime I could. Because it's just the kind of person that I am. And she gave me a car for free.
Oh my god. Bitch, stop crying. Look, I cry at a lot of shit. I cry a good bit. But god damn. Come on, guys, stop yoking about the egg already. Oh my god. I am the kind one. No egg jokes for me. I keep my yolks separated. God fucking... Yes, we love you, Mango. Even if we like being mean to you sometimes. And that's fair. I torture y'all with this stuff, so it... It's even. You're egging Mano on. It's not nice. She is unhinged in a whole bunch of ways. She's very unhinged. She's a super unhinged lady. And that woman was Barb Chandler. No! Oh my god. Yeah, Naked and Laughing. I knew. She is definitely unhinged in all ways. We're all walking on eggshells around her the way this chat is going. She is a shell of her former self. Am I talking about Jessica or a future Mango? You guys suck. You guys suck so fucking much. Oh my god. What is wrong with y'all? Why are y'all so mean? Yeah, my jokes sometimes fall flat. Sunny side up, you could say. I say that y'all are... Why? Yeah, I love you guys too. I would tell an egg joke, but mine is a bit runny. This conversation leaves a lot of time for us to hatch more jokes about eggs. God fucking... I think all these puns are excellent. God damn it. Oh my fucking god. You guys are ridiculous. I love you all. Thank you, Reaper. I appreciate the hugs. Oh my god. Well, laughter can be the best medicine. I have to miss some work for reasons this week. If y'all would like to help us reach this goal, so that way I can be just a little bit less stressed and dealing with less shit, it would be very much appreciated. If not, like, it's your money. Do with it as you please. But it right now would be very fucking much appreciated. So, there are the links. What we are going to do, because I'm tired of Naked and Laughing, we're going to watch a Bad Food. Such great execution. I can read, I can words on all these puns. God fucking. Okay, that's it. We're switching over to Bad Food. Before we switch over to Bad Food, why don't we we'll watch another fat photog, and then we'll watch this terrible recipe.
It takes years to hone the skills of debate, but who the fuck has time for that bullshit?
Fights of nature during predetermined things that you have no control over, but there's also no God, so it doesn't matter.
Forge your own path.
You kind of are retarded.
With Bravo de Cristo School of Master Debating.
I am just obeying the physical quantum mechanics of my nature. Oh! Get it to yourself! We're all impersonal entities with no free will or consciousness of our own! We're just acting in accordance with natural law!
Fuck traditional debate skills.
Cause, oh yeah, I got one over on Nick Bravo.
Stink!
I know exactly what's going on.
Flourish them with nonsensical machinations.
Oh, you're so wonderful, and you have so much valor and courage. Oh, you are a Marine!
And that means I have the right to treat people like shit.
I'm a veteran, see everybody? Veteran. You have to be nice to me. You have to respect me.
Don't give a fuck!
Yep, I agree. Oh, the world is ending.
Look at me roll my eyes. It doesn't matter. Samuel Cotton.
Desecrate my images as a veteran.
Bravo de Cristo School of Master Debating. Lifting hearts, minds, and fat folds since 2023.
I'm a good person because I'm a veteran.
Also, thank you, Griffin Doggo, Brandon the Trash King, and Brainless. Now we have a really weird goal total, but I appreciate y'all. And the egg jokes. I do appreciate the egg jokes. Place pin. There we go. Yes, this will be our last video before we get out of here. Let's see. And yes, Mari. Don't worry. I know it's okay to rest, and I know I should rest, and I promise that I will get rest after this. But until then, we're going to watch it.
An easy and flavorsome recipe for your dinner. In a bowl, add 750 grams of beef mince, one egg, 1 cup of breadcrumbs, 1 grated onion, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of mild paprika, and mix well. Write in the comments where you're watching us so that I can prove to know.
My favorite part about this is that they're recipes. Oh, my Wi-Fi dropped really hard. Probably because of the eclipse. But why is there porn music? This porn music. Look here, listen. They're on a budget, okay? But no, you've got a real person making this real recipe. But you also have the AI voice that's doing the reading of it, which is even better. Like, I love this. It's fantastic. Are they gonna fuck the bowl? This music is confusing me. Yes. Don't forget some ginger. It should help as well as the Pedialyte. Yes, I will remember. I will remember. Wait, you have audio on during the porn? Depends on the porn. Depends on the porn.
After mixing, set the beef aside. In another bowl, add 200 grams of grated cheese, 1 chopped onion, 1 grated carrot, and mix well. On a plate, put a big chunk of plastic film and spread the beef mince on it using your hands. You guys, this recipe is easy and a different way for you to have lunch or dinner. It tastes incredible. It's totally worth it. Spread the beef mince and then add the cheese.
It does not seem worth it. It just does not seem worth it to me. I'm using a lot of bowls here, lady. You guys. At least she washed her hands between. Yeah, I'll give her that. But also, like, this is just... To me, this is so random. This is just... Who makes this besides these people? Who thinks this is a good idea? You're just gonna fill meat with cheese, onion, and carrot? It's like a Swiss roll, but not. Yeah, can we do not this? I would appreciate doing not this. I was just about to try this. Oh my god, brainless. Do not that.
Mixture. This will be our filling. And if you're still watching the video, you're loving the recipe, then like the video and comment below, I love rolls. Finally, close the ends so the filling won't leak. Put it in the fridge for 2 hours. After 2 hours, remove the plastic film.
Ugh, the music is just... It's so unnecessarily loud. Like, I understand that you've got your free music, but... You can adjust the audio. I love rolls. I don't love rolls. I love rolls, but not shanties. If she eats this raw, she won't. She's going to cook it. Don't worry. She's going to cook it. That's some big meats. Yeah, that's a big log of meat. Oh, she's going to use it as a toy. That's why the music's there. Got you. Got you.
Grease a baking pan with oil and put the roll inside. oil the top, then put it in the oven at 390 degrees Fahrenheit for 50 minutes. And our recipe is done.
What was the 2 hours for? Fantastic question. It can help with the binding of the meat. That's all. Just to help keep that log shape that she's going for. It's ground beef. It has enough grease in it already. Well, Jinyu, I think she disagrees.
Look how delicious it is. I hope you liked our recipe. Now I'm going to reply to your comments. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
Look at that turd log. I don't see the point. I'm just going to stop that video there. Alright, so this has been an interesting stream. It's been a fun time. I've appreciated having all of y'all here. I'm going to make Small Human a snack before the eclipse is visible here. I do not feel good. I'm also probably going to lay down after. But, yeah. I appreciate every single one of y'all. We have made it to this much left of the goal. If you help after the fact, then I will reduce it from that total for the next time I stream. I don't know if I'm streaming tomorrow or not. That is up in the air. But yeah. We absolutely appreciate y'all. As Widow says, it doesn't look very good. No, it doesn't. Of course, Shaw. I'm glad that I could be entertaining. I'm going to go stare at the sun. Yes, go do that. Yes, Slim will be streaming later. He will be doing a lot of fun shit. So go over to his channel. Check it out. Slim posted the link. Or Brainless posted the link. God damn it. I'm having a day. But yeah. Thank you all. I've enjoyed every bit of this. As always, in the description, there's Stream Purse I'm on the stream yard with. There's the Petty Fam. There's Tito and Yato. Tito's funnier than Yato. There's my list of US resources. I hope that y'all have a fantastic rest of your day, and even better tomorrow, and I will see y'all on the next one. Bye, guys.